Good morning. You're watching News for Hearing Impaired. I'm Preeti. With me is Sonu. First, the headlines we're tracking this hour. Pakistan resorts to heavy shelling in the LOC area. All border areas on high alert. Home Minister Rajnath Singh asks BSF to give befitting reply. Meanwhile, two Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorists arrested in Baramulla. India declares Pakistan High Commission staffer persona non grata for espionage, asks him to leave within 48 hours. Pakistan retaliates by declaring Indian High Commission official persona non grata. Cabinet clears 500 crore rupees special horticulture package for Jammu and Kashmir. Package expected to create 3,000 to 20,000 jobs in the state, aims to provide help to farmers affected by floods in 2014. Centre approves 2% DNS allowance, move to benefit over 1 crore staff and pensioners. Cabinet gives in principle nod for strategic sale of PSUs, including those that are making profits. Bengaluru police arrest 4 persons in connection with the murder of RSS worker. The RSS worker was killed in broad daylight on 16th of October in Bengaluru. No end to Samajwadi Party feud. Amar Singh says it hurt him when Akhilesh called him a power broker. Mulayam Singh sends Shivpali Yadav to Delhi to explore possibilities of grand alliance with Congress, JDU and RLD in Uttar Pradesh. Dalai Lama is free to travel to Arunachal Pradesh or any other part of the country, says India. Sets aside China's claims over parts of Arunachal. Those were the headlines. Now the news in detail. In the latest incidents of ceasefire violation in Jammu and Kashmir, Pakistani forces resorted to heavy shelling in Hira Nagar sector of Kathua district and Samba sector along the international border and Krishna Ghati sector in Pooch district along the line of control on Saturday evening. After shelling from across the border in Kathua and Hira Nagar areas, local residents are migrating to safer places. Locals say this has never happened before, such heavy firing from Pakistan. People have left the village as everyone is so scared. SHO Mohammed Yunus Chaudhry in Rajouri said that we are ready and we don't want any casualties. This is heavy shelling. We have asked locals to stay indoors. Earlier, Pakistani forces overnight resorted to heavy mortar shelling in Arispura sector that had left a BSF Jawan martyred, while at least 6 civilians were injured. In retaliation to Pakistani firing, BSF has claimed that one Pakistani ranger was killed and another was critically injured in cross-border firing in Arispura sector along the international border on Thursday afternoon. Meanwhile, Pakistan also resorted to firing in Krishna Ghati and Mendhar sectors. An infiltration raid from Pakistan was foiled at Tangdhar. 2 Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorists arrested from Baramulla in Jammu and Kashmir in a joint search operation by 46 Rashtra Rifles and Special Operation Group. Home Minister Rajnath Singh spoke to BSF DG on heavy shelling in the LOC area from across the border. The Home Minister has directed DG BSF to respond appropriately in case of any unprovoked firing from Pakistan, but has also asked them not to fire first. DG BSF has also briefed NSA Ajit Dobhal on the ongoing fire at the LOC. All border areas have been put on high alert. Army Chief General Dalbir Singh also briefed Defence Minister Manohar Parikar and National Security Advisor Ajit Dobhal on the LOC situation. Amid ceasefire violations, Indian Army troops are bracing for an offensive by Pakistan's border action teams that may try to take revenge for surgical strikes. Speaking on the incident, Deputy Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, Nirmal Singh, has said that forces are giving befitting reply to ceasefire violations by Pakistan Rangers. He also added that losses following Pakistan's shelling in the civilian area is being assessed and arrangements are being made to compensate the losses. Pakistan is being exposed on all fronts. Terrorism, radicalization, crackdown on democratic dissent and clandestine activities like espionage. Pakistan High Commission staffer Mehmood Akhtar has been asked to leave India within 48 hours. Akhtar was detained by Delhi police for his involvement in espionage activities. Later, he was let off. External Affairs Ministry spokesperson said in New Delhi last evening that Akhtar was declared persona non grata and he, along with his family, has to leave India by this Saturday. The staffer, Akhtar, who had worked in visa section of the High Commission and has diplomatic immunity, was procuring critical details from two other accomplices who have been arrested and have been sent to police custody. Meanwhile, Pakistan retaliates by declaring an official of Indian High Commission persona non grata. Now, Singh has been asked to leave Pakistan by Saturday. Pakistan Foreign Secretary has expressed deep concern over activities of Sarjeet Singh, violative of Vienna Convention and establishing diplomatic norms. In what could come as a major relief to apple growers in Jammu and Kashmir who lost their crop in the floods that lashed the state in 2014, Union Cabinet has decided to relax norms under Mission for Integrated Development of Horticulture to help them restore their orchards and also help new apple growers in setting up new orchards. For the horticulturists in Jammu and Kashmir, fund of 500 crore rupees was approved by Cabinet for three financial years up to March 2019. The centre's fiscal share in it will be 90%, which is 450 crore rupees. Now, this is a significant decision since horticulture is the mainstay of Kashmir's economy. In other key decisions ahead of Diwali, Cabinet has approved 2% dearness allowance and relief benefiting over 50 lakh central government employees and over 54 lakh pensioners. The decision will be effective from 1st of July this year. Earlier, the Union government had pushed up DA for the first half of this year by 6%. The combined impact on the exchequer on account of both DNS allowance and DNS relief would be around 5,600 crore per annum. Besides, the Union Cabinet has also given in-principle approval to Niti Aayog's proposal for strategic sale of state-owned firms and entrusted the Department of Investment and Public Asset Management with the task of finalizing the PSUs in which management control can be transferred to private players. The war within Samajwadi Party is seeing no signs of receding. After weeks of feuding in the Samajwadi Party between members of the family, Rajya Sabha MP and the man in the eye of the storm, Amar Singh, broke his silence. Now, Amar Singh, considered by many as the real bone of contention between the warring Yadav factions, has broken his silence. The SP General Secretary said that he was hurt when Akhilesh called him a dalal or a power broker, hoping to keep his flock together and contain damage caused by factionalism within his party. SP President Mulayam Singh is toying with the idea of a pre-poll grand alliance with Congress, JDU and RLD in Uttar Pradesh. Mulayam Singh has sent his confidant Shivpal Yadav to Delhi to explore possibilities. Meanwhile, if the SP is trying to hit the tracks running, BJP is already sprinting at full tilt. BJP National President Amit Shah held a Sankalp rally in heart of Mulayam's hometown Itawa on Thursday. Four men have been arrested in Bengaluru in connection with the murder of RSS worker Rudresh earlier this month. Rudresh has been hacked to death by two men on a motorbike in broad daylight in the central and busy Shivajinagar area of Bengaluru on 16th of October. Bangalore Police Commissioner N.S. Megharik told media persons that the murderers had been known to Rudresh and are from Bengaluru. He said the murder was for personal motives and was not politically motivated. Interrogation of the accused, Wasim Ahmed, Mujib, Sadiq and Infan Pasha is still on. It is said that one of the men, Mujib, had been updated others on Rudresh's movements. The murder had drawn protests from RSS and the BJP with prohibitory orders imposed in parts of the city. The funeral procession for Rudresh also took place under tight security as RSS said that the murder was part of a series of attacks on RSS workers, many of which have taken place in neighbouring Kerala. Prime Minister Narendra Modi met all secretaries to the Government of India on Thursday in a meeting where cabinet ministers and ministers for state for independent charge were also present. 10 new groups of secretaries are being formed who will submit their reports on various governance issues by the end of November. As compared to earlier groups which worked on specific themes, the focus of the groups this time will be on sectors such as agriculture, energy, transport, etc. The Prime Minister complimented them for the work done by them as part of the 8 thematic groups in the month of January. He urged them to undertake a critical review of the work done by Union Government in respective sectors that they will be studying. He also asked them to engage youth officers to research related issues. Speaking to Demographic Dividend, the Prime Minister said that all groups must prioritize harnessing the strength of the 800 million youth of India as part of their recommendations. Government of India has cleared Dalai Lama's proposed visit to Arunachal Pradesh early next year. Dalai Lama was extended an invitation by Arunachal Pradesh Chief Minister Pema Khandu on 9th of October in Delhi to visit Arunachal Pradesh. The visit is slated for second week of March in 2017. The move assumed significance as China raised objections to U.S. Ambassador Richard Verma's visit to Tawang on 21st of October for Tawang Festival. India dismissed it by saying that it is nothing unusual as Arunachal is an integral part of India. Excitement for Diwali festivities is warming up the environment as we head towards an electrifying weekend to celebrate Diwali. Today is Dhanteras, the first day of the 5-day-long Diwali festival. The city markets are all decked up in multicolored lights and decorations. Traders have filled their shelves with latest goods and are making all efforts to meet the demands of the customers. God. The day is dedicated to the originator of Ayurveda and the teacher of all physicians, Dhanvantari. People generally buy gold, silver or some utensils on the occasion of Dhanteras. People also perform pujas and follow other rituals to celebrate the occasion. That's it in this edition of the News This Hour. Thanks for watching. Namaskar.